This is how the fast idle screw works on an FJ40 carb. And here we've got the overview of the carb. This is the side that faces the manifold and the valve cover. And so if you pull the choke circuit, it rotates here, and this lever comes up and touches the fast idle screw. As it comes up, as I pull the choke all the way on, you see the fast idle screw where it's set raises the RPMs through the throttle circuit right there. Right there it touches it, and now it increases the RPMs. So that is how the fast idle screw works. The idle screw is the one that's on the bottom down here, poking through. Get a pointer right there, and it touches that plate just below it there, which also moves the throttle linkage. So as you tighten that screw, as I drop everything, as you tighten that screw down, it moves the plate below it. It's a little blurry. Hey, handheld cameras. So we'll tighten that down, and you see it moving the throttle circuit. There. So if you loosen it all the way until it is not touching that plate anymore, that is as loose as you can get it. Let's flip this over again. There. I don't know if I got it all the way loose or not, but you get what I mean. If I back that out a couple more turns, it's not going to be touching the throttle circuit at all, which is here. What is that? There we go. So let me hang this off the edge. All right. So if you have a throttle cable, it attaches here and pulls the throttle circuit. If you have the mechanical connector, goes right here and it pulls. I guess this way. Same thing. Let's see if we can get around and see that where the idle screw is. Get my hand under it. So it comes up and it meets that idle screw and it stops. So again, if you tighten it, move that down. If you loosen it all the way until it's not touching anymore, that's the lowest you can go. I'm pretty sure that's not touching anymore. Yeah. I don't know if you can see it though. I'm trying to get an angle on it with my camera the way it is. Here we go. There. You can see under there that is not touching that plate. It's backed out all the way. So if you kept backing it out, it's just going to fall out and it's not doing anything. So since I haven't seen any videos on how the FJ40 carburetor works, not that I understand it fully, I thought I would throw that in there. Also, while we're making things up, here's the main throttle circuit valve as it opens. As we pull down, open that, it opens. There we go. And the secondary barrel cannot open until, it's right here, until this circuit is open. You see, once that right there clears, this circuit can open and they can both open up. So that's your second barrel of the carburetor. All right, that's the basics. That's about all I know because I'm just learning this myself, but thought I would make a video.